Hey, good morning, everyone. Welcome to our usual Monday morning color along, 10 a.m. here live on Facebook. I have some changes happening with my setup and my audio, so I'm hoping that you will let me know how my audio is, how can you hear me okay, can you see the color along book that's on the desk here. I just want to make sure my lighting is okay, and I want to make sure that my audio is okay. So let's say good morning to everyone, see if anyone can hear me. Good morning to Bonnie Hughes and Sandra. Good morning, good morning. Good morning to Mary Ann, Melody, Mary Hannah. Good morning. Good morning, Debbie. Sharon, good morning, good morning. Kerry, good afternoon. Sarah, how's it going? Hey, good morning, Melody. Haven't seen you in a while. So this morning we are coloring another page from Color Along Volume 14. And today we're using glitter gel pens. And I'm also going to be using makeup in the background. So I've got some glitter gel pens with me. I have a variety of gel pens today. I'm not going to be using a particular brand, but rather I'm just going to be using a variety of Gel Writer, Smooth, and Pop Sockets, the Pentel Pop Sockets. How's my audio, Mary and Marianne? Hey, good morning, Cheryl, Naomi. Jean's here with us this morning. Good morning to Mamie. So we've got a couple of things happening this morning besides today's color along. We're going to be announcing the winner of the summer camp PDF coloring book that was donated or sponsored by an anonymous colorist. I'm gonna make sure everyone can hear me though. Can you hear me? Thank you, Debbie. Okay. I was talking and talking and thinking, I'm talking and asking if anyone can hear me. And how, like, crazy is that if I am going to just keep asking that question and no one can hear me? Hello? Right? Okay. Back to the beginning here. So many other people are joining us. Good morning, Alexandria. Good to see you. Heather, how are you? So, a couple of things happening today. We're coloring a page from Color Along Volume 14 today. We're coloring the Dangles page. Which is this page, and I'm going to be using glitter gel pens. I've got a variety of gel pens, pops, Pentel, sparkle pops. I was like pop sockets. I don't know. I'm having a rough day today, and it's only what 10 o'clock in the morning. This is crazy. Smooth gel pens, gel writer, and I think I have some Sakura jelly rolls. So I've got a variety. Just gonna kind of bounce around. The other thing I'm going to be doing this morning is doing the background with makeup. So I have these cheapo eyeshadows from, I think, Dollar Tree or Family Dollar or something. And I'm going to be doing the background with the makeup. So let's put that over to the side. And the next thing I'm going to talk about is, we're going to get it right out. I got to like talk about it right out the get-go here, is that we had a giveaway for the summer camp book. And the person would win the book, summer camp book, in PDF format so that it would be available worldwide. And that would get you into the summer camp from July 19th to July 25th for that whole week. So it's rather than buying the book. So, this was sponsored by an anonymous colorist. This has happened before. Always such an incredible gesture on it. Validates or just reinforces my theory that the nicest people exist in the coloring community. I mean, that is just, wouldn't you all say? So an anonymous colorist sponsored it, and we are ready to announce the winner. Are we ready to hear this winner? I'm so excited that this person has won. I mean, I would have been excited for anyone to win. Hey, Dawn, Lynn, good morning. This morning, the winner of the summer camp PDF book that will get access to the camp for that week of July 19th to 25th is Marianne Manders. So congratulations to Marianne. Marianne is the winner of that that giveaway. My dogs are crazy today. I hope Marianne is here. Is Marianne here? Sarah's saying, thanks for the bookmark. She's talking about an event that's happening in the Coloring Heels, so Color More coloring group. If you've not seen that, there's an event happening there, and there's some free bookmarks that you can print. I have not really been paying too much attention to what's happening. I know that somebody was coloring something. What were they coloring today? Was something from Jeanette's books? Jeanette Wummel, I'm gonna get Scarlett her pencil here. Hold on a second. Is Marianne here? I thought she was here. I'll be emailing Marianne that book today. So excited. Oh, Tyne is coloring. Okay, Tyne is the one that's coloring over in the Juts. In the coloring, he also colored more coloring book. So this page is from my book, Dangled Coloring Book for All. And it kind of, I don't even have a copy of this because I just recently sold this book again. But I'm just going to jump right in with these Pentel Sparkle Pops, and it's all about glitter. So I've got a variety, like I said, but I do have a piece of paper behind. I actually have two behind here because I just don't want the pressure of the pen to go through. Hey, good morning, Lisa. So we're just going to start out with coloring this little guy's head. I've got this brown glitter pen, and this is a gel writer pen. You can really hear my dogs like click clack, clickety clickety clack walking around. So there's his head, and I always kind of like to give these guys a funky little look to their, around their whiskers, I guess. So I'm going to make it yellow, and I'm going to give him some yellow ears because it's fantasy. We can do whatever we want. We don't have to wear, we don't have to wear clothes. We don't have to wear clothes where we are in our fantasy land. No, go follow the rules. We don't have to color things the way they're supposed to. You can color it any old way you want, right? Good morning, D. I'll give him a pink nose because why not, right? And then I think I'll give this guy kind of a blue. See, this one's not working. Sometimes the gel pens get stuck. Does anyone else have this problem with gel pens getting stuck? And they say to hit them on your hand like that, but I'm not really sure if that's the way to do it or not. I think I might zoom in a little bit to this. There we go. Just a little bit more. I kind of have my gel pens all living together in one box. I don't know if that's good or bad. We talk about this, right? We talk about this all the time, about where our coloring supplies live. Do they live together? Do they have separate places that they live? And then this book just kind of has all these little dangling things. Everybody's dangling in this book. It's got a variety of hearts and dogs and cats and different geometric shapes. And it's just a whimsical, fun little book. I think it was Bonnie Hughes who said that she really likes this book. This was fun to draw. Good morning, Alice. And who else joined? Diana. Good morning, good morning. So what is new in the coloring world? Anything new and exciting? Anybody want anything that's cool and fun? I thought I had a red, but I don't see that. So I'm going to go with this orange Pentel Sparkle Pop. If you've not used these Sparkle Pop pens, they're very juicy, as they say, in the gel pen world. And sometimes the colors change. I know if you use black, it changes to red. I don't really know why. Why does that happen? Isn't that weird? I like them, but sometimes it is a little bit of a surprise as far as what something has changed to. This is a jelly roll, metallic glitter. They're all in the same family, if you ask me. I'm gonna give this dude some yellow ears. And I'll give this guy a blue body. I think of these dogs as having clothes on, not having a body. Sneak peek inside my head. Thank you, Heather. Heather says it's a cute book. Thank you. Dawn's saying, my other gel pens are all in containers according to color. Oh my goodness, you're very organized. The only ones that are separate are my colored gel pens because they came in their own case. I don't think I could do it according to color. I mean, maybe. I don't know. Maybe I could, Dawn. I'll have to see. I've been on a cleaning fit and a cleaning binge lately anyway, so maybe I'll add it to my cleaning. I don't know what's happened to me. Do you ever go on, has anyone have that happen? You go on like a kick of just cleaning like a nut. I'll give him some red toes and feet. Hey, Marianne. Congratulations. I didn't know if you were still here or not. Congratulations. I'm so excited. So I'll be emailing that book to you later on today. And I'll add you to the camp group. Camp is going to be exciting this time. We're going to do a lot of different things. We're doing grayscale painting. What else are we doing? I have a piece of paper somewhere. Let's look at it. We're doing basic color theory. That's going to be cool. We've never done that before at camp or any type of live video. Tie-dye. We're going to work on burnishing. We're going to draw the camp hut. Grayscale painting, speckled, and then ocean, sky, and land. That was a request a lot of people made about learning how to draw clouds. So that's where that's going to kind of fit in. It doesn't really use less space, Dawn. I don't know if I would think. I wouldn't think that it would. I don't know where my cap went for this one. Oh, here it is. Debbie is saying, mine are by color also. Thanks to Jean Mellinger for the gift of a carry case she sent me. Oh, nice. See, isn't it amazing how nice people are? People think that people are not nice, but they are. They're obviously not coloring. Okay, that one doesn't work. How about this purple? Yes. The purple is working. So amazing that we've had donate books before in the past, not just for camp, but for other coloring books. And a couple of people, and I'm not going to tell you this because I'm asking anyone to do this by any means at all. But a few people have asked me, like, how do you do it? What happens? How does that work? And the way it works is you just get in touch with me, say that you want to sponsor a giveaway, and then I set it up as a giveaway. And then when it comes time to pick the winner, then you just purchase the book, and then we get it to that person. It could be a hard copy book that you actually ship from your own, you purchase it, and then you ship it out. Or we opted to do a PDF this time around because this way anyone could enter. It could be worldwide because we don't want to start shipping to, like, I don't know, Costa Rica or something crazy, right? We want to make sure that we can ship where it's affordable to actually ship somewhere. Paisley, why don't you come over here with us, my friend? Come here. Paisley. I feel like I have to check every single pen to make sure they're okay. Paisley, come over here and lay down. Sit down. Lay down. Lay down. Come on, lay down. Paisley and her, stay there. It's a good girl. That's her real voice, right? My son bought me painting supplies for Mother's Day. You know, painting supplies are in short supply, aren't they? What did you get? Did you get anything good, Alice? I have to go let this dog out. Hang on a second, folks. I'll let you catch up to what we're doing here while I go let Paisley go. Come on, Paisley. Okay, sorry about that. Paisley's testing my patience today, apparently. Dawn is saying, I just ordered the acrylic paint pens from Arteza. Oh, I can't wait to see how those are. You'll have to tell us about them. Alice has three canvas panels, acrylic paints, and brushes. I actually went to Dollar Tree yesterday. I was having Dollar Tree withdrawals because I hadn't been going to Dollar Tree. But yesterday I decided that I should go and get some canvases, and they had a lot, actually. Much more than I thought they would have. Go back to my red color. So I'm going to color all of this with the glitter gel pens and then go back in and add the makeup to the background. Add some more yellow to this. I think I'll do this one as a yellow heart. So this is just kind of like a fun little whimsical book. I had a lot of fun drawing this book, actually. Easy to color because a lot of them have, well, most of the pages anyway, have a pretty good empty background. So it's really kind of cool that you can add a lot of things to the background. That was Paisley that just threw herself onto the floor. Oh my goodness. I don't know. My dogs are very routine. Which Dollar Tree did you go to? I went to the one in the Shaw's Plaza, Sharon. Matter of fact, you're on my list today to send them. I was going to send you a message when I was done with this to let you know. They had 8x10 stretched. They had plastic palette knives, which I bought. What else did they have? It was a quick trip, though, because I didn't really want to be in there for very long. There were a lot of people in there. I thought they were limiting people for the number of people that were going in the store. Not so when I got there. I don't know. I think I'm a little confused about the rules about what is happening out in the world and like limits of people and number of people in the store and what you can and cannot do. I don't know. I feel like I need clarification. Anyone else feeling like this? It's very strange. They also had some smaller stretch canvas, Sharon, but they were like 4x6 maybe and some canvas panels. Alice is saying, everyone loved the painting from Coloring Camp, and my son thinks I need to do more. You do. I agree. I have more virtual paint parties scheduled. I just finished a virtual paint party the other day. We did a vase of flowers. Did anyone see the vase of flowers that people have been posting from that one? We did that one on Friday. The next virtual paint party that's coming up is next Sunday, the 24th. And I actually have the painting in front of me. This is the painting that we're doing on the 24th. That's the next virtual paint party. If you take a look at the June calendar, which has been posted on my Facebook page and on the Just Color Coloring group, you can see everything that has happened in June. A few things are going to be, a few changes are being made to what I've been doing in the past. And one of the things that's happening is Draw Live is going to be a pre-recorded video. And I'm doing that so that it's gonna free up some times to do some other things. So I'm doing that, and so the next Draw Live video, it'll be scheduled for this Thursday, actually, so that's the date it'll be released. And then going forward, every month we'll have, some Draw Live videos released on particular days. So I hope that it works out. We're gonna test it, at least. Test it out, see how it goes, and then I'm going to be adding some new things. Have a couple of new projects that I'll be working on that'll be totally different, and trying to keep things fresh and exciting, right? Mary saying, I don't think people are following the rules, Bonnie saying. Mary saying, I have a feeling these guidelines will be a very mixed bag. Well, I don't think people are following the rules either. There was a big to-do in my area yesterday with college graduations. People having parades. What's up with that? People having parades. I was driving down the street the other day. I almost got into an accident because somebody was driving down the street having a parade for someone that, for their friend that graduated from law school, maybe. And I just thought to myself, you know, I've never been a fan of a parade anyway, but I think you're right, Mary. I think it's a mixed bag. I'll give this guy some brown around his nose. And then I guess I'll do some yellow up here. And give him some yellow ears. Throw in a pink nose. And this guy can have a yellow head too. Because these are fantasy dogs, right? Little pink nose here. I'll do all the noses next. This guy cracks me up. Let's see what other color I have in here that I might have missed. Oh, this is a purple color. Give this one a purple heart. Because hearts don't have to be red all the time, right? They can be purple. They can be any color you would want them to be. And this guy, I think I'll give him some, like a little brown snout there. I call that the snout. Or the jowls. Is that the jowls, I think? Maybe. Oh, Cheryl's asking me a question here. Does that mean that you will not be doing the Wednesday draw along live? No, the only change, did you see the June calendar? The only change, this is the June calendar that's been posted on my Facebook page and on the coloring group. So let me just kind of give you an idea of what's happening. Everything stays the same except for draw live. So color alongs remain live, continuing on Monday mornings at 10 a.m. Draw alongs live all the time. Wednesday mornings, private group. In order to participate in the draw alongs, which are live, you need to have the draw along book. We're in a private group and we draw live together. So that's more of a drawing class type thing. Then draw live is when I draw two coloring pages live here on Facebook and then they go into a future book. But there's really not haven't been very many viewers for that. So I'm going to try something a little bit new and I'll be releasing a pre-recorded video of the draw live pages. And then people that have memberships with me will receive those two draw live pages in an email within the 24 hours after they are drawn and released. And then I've got a couple of virtual paint parties happening on June 7th. And then on June 26th, I've got this pots of lavender painting here and this little Mr. Bird. So that's what's happening. Does that answer your question, Cheryl? I hope so. I got to get back to these comments. Alice is saying, I know I'm confused too. I have to take Cleo to the vet Thursday and they tell me to call them when I get there and the vet will come on and get her. Me too. I have to do the same thing when I take the dog. Can't even go in. They're planned on wearing a mask, but they won't let me go in. I know. I've been postponing and I've been avoiding and delaying making a vet appointment because I don't want to send my dog in alone. Is that bad? Am I being like a helicopter pet parent? Am I being too overprotective by doing that? I mean, what if they find something? How am I going to know? How am I going to be able to talk about what's going on with her? I saw somebody, one time I had to go pick something up outside the vet, at the vet, and I waited outside and they brought me out. I think it was heartworm medicine. And I saw them talking with another person who was holding the puppy while they were doing like the pre-paperwork, like talking about what's happened with the puppy. And I did not like what was happening because first of all, there's no fence around the vet, that's another topic that I don't even want to get into. I'm actually considering, Alice, using a mobile vet because at least I could be there. I mean, I guess I could be there for a mobile vet. Dude, that would be even scarier though, right? Put the dog inside a van and then see it drive away. I don't know. Where was my head? Not sure how this is going to go, Mamie's saying. Already yesterday, people may have been exposed to the virus at a barbershop. Oh my God, you're kidding. Marianne is excited to go to camp. I'm excited you're going to go to camp too. Oh no, Bonnie Hume says a priest at our church has the virus. Sarah says, if you do draw live, you mean if I don't draw live, you won't get my feedback. I agree with you, Sarah, but I'm not getting feedback anyway because there's really not very many people that are there. So we're going to try it. We're going to try it for the next few months and see how it goes. And the people that I really, we're just going to see how it goes. You got to go with the flow and make some changes. Dawn has a good point. Depends on how your dog is at the vets. You know, Scarlett is a nervous Nelly when she goes to the vet. So, to be honest with you, it might be better if I'm not there. Isn't that terrible? No, really, though, I think she's nervous because I'm standing there. Maybe without me, she would be just like a perfect patient. And maybe she's just making a big deal in front of me. You know how they get, right? Those crazy dogs. Put a little bit of brown on top of this guy's head. And right here. And then I'll give him some brown paws. I'm afraid that she's gonna get on the, they're gonna get on the scale and they're gonna just say they're fat or something, you know? That's my fear. I'm embarrassed for them. What if they get on the scale and they don't put the, they just say that they're just too heavy. No one will be there to defend them and say, but I'm really not. Naomi says, they call you after they examine the pup over the phone to talk about what they find. Oh, gotcha, Naomi. I still don't like it. I don't. Do people have to take their kids to the doctor and just send the kid in alone? Plus, I don't know. I don't like it. I'm being a stickler about it. That's clarified, Cheryl. Sorry about the confusion. I didn't mean to confuse anyone. So now these sections here, you could actually kind of do your own little thing. Like you can put these little dots here, and I think I'll kind of go over that with yellow. Put a blue end here. These drawings in this book kind of remind me of almost like a Frank Lloyd Wright style. Frank Lloyd Wright was an architect, very angular and modern style drawings, and kind of reminds me of, they also kind of remind me of stained glass for some reason. I don't know why, but I guess it depends on the colors. Yeah, I get the talk all the time, Naomi. We get the talk. Too many snacks. You know, they have to say that. I gotta get my dogs to learn how to, like, take one paw off the scale when they weigh them. Lola was the one who went, Dawn is saying, and she usually clings to me when I am there, but she did fine without me. Olivia does fine. And yes, they called to make to let you know how much it went, what is wrong, and how much it costs. Of course, how much it costs, right? Hey, Omana. Let's see if I missed anybody in this section here. I did not. So I'm just going to concentrate on these upper portions here. And I think I have a lot of gel pens. I think I just have too many, that more than I would ever use. This is gold. Let's see if we can put some gold in there. You can tell that they're glitter by having, they have little specks all over them that looks like glitter. And I'm just going to add some gold to this section here and try to go around those little dots. And then, where is that blue? I'm gonna go with some blue right here. Miriam saying, we had three dogs in our family and they had to be put to sleep. Oh no, I'm so sorry to hear that. One of my son-in-law and two for my son. Oh, that's the worst feeling, isn't it? A horrible, horrible feeling. These dogs are heartbreakers. So this is just a green color here. Almost looks like a bluish green, right? A turquoise color in a way. That's what I was talking about how they change color like that. Isn't that weird? And then for behind that one, I think I'll add some pink. Just want to make sure that it works though. So I've got my little like scratch paper going on behind me here. See, some of them get stuck. Let's add some orange. My friend orange. And then this guy right up here could have something colored in. And you can even kind of add more space to everything, like as far as more lines to things to enclose things and maybe add some more something else to what's up top here. So it kind of gives you room and opportunity to kind of to even do your own thing. And then we've got this guy up here. I'm going to go with this purple. It's like the tightest cap ever. Naomi's saying, without that, there's a huge front window that you can look into the lobby where they do most of the exam, so you can helicopter parent, but through a glass window. That is a really, really good idea. That's a really good idea. I was talking about this, well, maybe they should do the same thing. I saw a restaurant, but we were talking about this with the other day, about taking like a greenhouse and putting it inside my house and sitting inside the greenhouse inside a room. I know, weird, right? But they should do that. They should have those little like glass greenhouses and they could be inside that, inside the vet. And then you could be in the waiting room looking inside. That's what I would do. I saw a restaurant that was using those for outdoor dining. I think we're gonna see some pretty interesting things happening. What people are doing, people are going to get really creative. Naomi is saying, thank you, Marianne. Naomi is saying that we lost a dog in the middle of it. So I'm so sorry. We found out he had cancer that spread to multiple organs. We tried to do surgery to save him, but there was nothing else the vet could do. Sorry to hear about that, Naomi. Were you able to be with the dog when they put, when through all of it though? That's my concern. I don't want to have to not do that. Put some yellow right here to this section. Mary says, my son had a pet dentist that wouldn't parent. His wife was a receptionist and they were nasty to moms who wanted to go in. I know sometimes, but yeah, I guess I can, you know, sometimes the kid is better with the parent, without the parent there, right? And I think sometimes the dog is probably better without. I don't know. It's on my list of things to do this week. Schedule a vet appointment. So I'm just going to add this brown color to this section here. But isn't it kind of looking like stained glass in a way? It's kind of cool. And then for the background, I'm going to add makeup. I've got eyeshadow with me. This Dollar Tree eyeshadow. Fancy colors. I don't know. Who wears this hot pink? Does anyone wear this hot pink eyeshadow? If you do, good for you. More power to you, let me tell you. Hey, good morning, Julie. Let's see if this turquoise color has anything left in it. Yes. And sometimes the paper, when you're using gel pens, sometimes the paper will get kind of clogged in the tip, so you have to kind of clean it. Okay, so that was a little different, Naomi. It's hard, isn't it? All right, so now let's see what else we've got going on here. It's time for the makeup, that's the best part. Now, sometimes I use the little, like, applicator that it comes with. It makes you, Lisa says, it makes me feel pretty and pink. This eyeshadow, I figured that you might use it. What's crazier? I wonder when I bought this, the reaction. Hey, Julie, about the person that was at the register and wondering to himself, wow, I can't believe she's going to wear this. Little did he know that I was going to color with it, and I think that would make me even more of a kook. All right, I'm just going to add some of this blue because I kind of wanted to have a blue background, and I've got it on my little applicator. By the way, makeup brushes make wonderful paint brushes, and there's some Wet n Wild paint brushes on Amazon right now. If you do a search on Amazon for Wet n Wild makeup brushes, they're like 59 cents to 88 cents. I have a couple of them. I love them. They have a white bristle to them. Makeup brushes make wonderful paint brushes. And they're cheaper. Sometimes they're a lot cheaper. Sarah says, I wish that all the Sparkle Pop would at least sometimes say the main color, like the purple blue. The pink says the same. I mean, on white paper. I totally agree with you, Sarah. It is very frustrating to me. I'm kind of pushing down on this so that it gets those stripes. I want it to have that striped look to it. But if you notice, this makeup is resisting, or the glitter gel pens is resisting the makeup. So it's easy enough to go over this with makeup after I colored it. And if I had done this the opposite way, if I had put the makeup on, then gel pens would not have been able to go on the paper. So that the makeup would have resisted the gel pens. Does that make sense? Heather is making a comment about eyeshadow is great for backgrounds. Fantastic. You know, there's Pan Pastels. It is an art supply. Very, very expensive. So if you cannot afford Pan Pastels, then go with makeup. Go with eyeshadow. Or even blush works out well. But it works out great on this smooth, if it's a smooth paper like this without any type of paper tooth. And you could go back in with an eraser and take it away from where you didn't want it to be. Or see how I'm getting that scratchy look to it, those lines. I'm just doing that by holding my applicator perpendicular to it. And now if I move up to the top, I've got some pink, Lisa's favorite color. I know she's wearing this today. Put some pink in here. Oh, I missed that little guy. Oh no, that's yellow. Okay, never mind. And I'll put some more pink up here. Thank you, Bonnie Hughes. I should do another book like this, don't you think? This was a lot of fun. It's so simple. I don't even have a copy of this book because I need to buy another copy of this. I'm gonna add some more blue to this section here. Let's pop some yellow in the bottom. And if you put yellow and blue, it'll make green. So it'll kind of look like the grass is at the bottom. That's my, could also add it with your fingers. They are fun to color, I agree with you. Right now I'm working on a grayscale book. All of my grayscale coloring books are marked down now. Matter of fact, a lot of my books are marked down, and they're going to remain at that price for only $5.99. So my grayscale coloring books on Amazon are only $5.99, and I'm actually working on a new one, grayscale landscape. So take a look at that. That should be coming out hopefully this week. By the end of the week, it will come out. Just need to finish up a few more pages in it, put the book together, and then that's really the only book I'm working on right now. I've got to get rid of these crumbs. Now, as far as, I don't really think I would seal it. I mean, I probably would put a piece of paper over it just to close the book, But nothing's going to happen to it. I mean, it's makeup, right? It barely comes off your face sometimes. You have to kind of scrub it away. But it's just leaving it the way it is. Marianne is saying, I like using makeup for backgrounds. I hate doing backgrounds, and eyeshadow is the easiest. I agree with you, too. Naomi says, would a brush work for the background for applying makeup? Yeah, it would, actually. If it was a stiffer paintbrush, though, you want it to have, or like a denser bristle brush. So you want the brush to have more, like, bristles together. So there's my kind of my grass at the bottom. And you could go back in and you can add whatever you wanted to this, but I'm just going to leave it the way it is. So let's see what the next one is. Our next color along is next Monday, which, can you believe it's going to be Memorial Day? I cannot believe it. I just can't. The 25th. Oh, this one's going to be fun. This one's from an original painting. And we'll be using chalk pastels for the next color along. I have a lot of blank pages in here. Here it is. It's also available in my book, Wonder, which is now priced at only $6.99 for Wonder. And we'll be using chalk pastel. This is from an original painting that I did, and I'll have that painting with me also so we can take a look at it. Let's see what else is coming up in the future here. This one is going to be Cole Outdoor Beauty Grayscale Coloring Book with colored pencils. And yeah, this one's just colored pencils. This is just a close-up of grass. Lynn is saying you can also use a cotton ball Q-tip. Very good point. Thank you, Lynn. And then this one here, we're going to just use just two colors. This is also another grayscale page. And then we've got bolding is another one we're going to be working on, another technique we'll be working on as we move through this book. Mixed media for these little angels from Tiny Crowds. Colored pencils and highlighters. Haven't done this one in a long time as far as this particular technique, but we'll be doing this for this 3D variety coloring book. And then here's Whimsical Dogs coloring book. This is pop art, which is all about really bold colors, especially primary yellow, red, and blue. And maybe add in some black also. This one is going to be warm colors from my Doggy Mosaic book. This is a little Afghan dog. I don't know if I would like to have one of those dogs, but too much brushing, right? This one is cool. This is 20 colors. This is always a challenge and a fun challenge to complete from this Itsy Bitsy book. And then as we move into August, wood grain effect. And then 3D coloring with colored pencils from that book, Happy Words. And then moving on with markers to a Bugs View coloring book. And I gotta say, I need to get a different set of markers. Anybody have any suggestions for something that's a non-toxic, low-odor marker? I don't want Sharpies or Bic markers. These alcohol markers are really taking my breath away. This one's Textures with Lines from Square Chains. And then here's another chalk pastel page we'll be doing that's original from a charcoal drawing. Then we'll be moving on to woodless colored pencils as we move into September. And then for the last color along for this book, we're going to create textures from this page with these four mandalas from my new mandalas. So that is where we're headed with the color along volume 14 book. So many people have also asked me what happens at a draw along. So let me show you what has been happening at a draw along. Draw alongs meet on Wednesdays at 10 a.m. and the replays are always available. Don't wish summer away. I wish that summer wasn't going to be hot. Is that a realistic wish to have, Sarah? watercolor markers. Good point, Naomi. I'll have to try that. I do like Faber-Castell grit markers. Maybe I'll just go back with my Faber-Castell. Or Crayola. I don't know. It's such decisions, right? Such decisions in your life. So draw alongs meet on Wednesdays at 10 a.m. And we meet in a private group. You get the book. This book is $28.99. And it gives you 12 lessons. It's 12 classes, basically. These are drawing classes. So let me show you what we've done so far. Each time we do a draw along, we start out with a warm-up sketching exercise. This one we did was basic boxes, and we kind of started out with this basic warm-up sketching exercise. may not make any sense as you look at this right now, but if you had followed along with the class, it would definitely have made sense. And then we drew these two boxes that were right here. And here is where we drew that. The next one we did was, here's our warm-up sketching exercise for our next one. And then we drew this still life with charcoal, and here's the one we did with charcoal. We've only had two of these classes so far. Naomi is saying the draw along classes are great. You know what? Thank you, Naomi. I think that it's worth the value, wouldn't you say? Because this book is $28.99. It's basically, you get 12 classes, and it's just a little bit over $2 per class. So if you can, where can you take a drawing class for $2 per class? So the book gets you everything. And then the videos are there. My Artist Loft markers don't smell, Sharon is saying, but they are also not the smoothest unless I don't use them correctly. They tend to leave lines within the space you're coloring. You might be pressing down too hard. Sometimes super tips do that. You would love Faber-Castell markers. The TY markers are water-based also, and the colors are great. TWI, Dawn? I'll have to take a look at those. I can't really use Copics. Sharon's saying, I love drawing classes. I've learned so much. Thank you. I think that it's incredible what we've done. So here's our still life with charcoal drawing that we've done. And then the other thing that happens, this is what we're doing this Wednesday. We're drawing this page. The other thing that happens, and I'm going to show you from the other book. If I can find it. I've rearranged my space, and I'm a little lost right now. This is the first volume we did, okay? So the other thing that happens is that in the draw along group, reference photos are posted, and they're kind of like challenges for everyone to draw throughout the week. So the back of the book has some other pages. So here's here's one that we did, these glass bottles. We drew this one. And then this one was fennel that we drew, just a quick sketch. Thank you, Dawn. This was an apple and a pear. So this was the Draw Along Volume 1 book. And I'll just to show you an idea of how we completed stuff, some variety, and then I'll show you the rest of the other Draw Along book. But and if you wanted to get this book also, if you wanted to get Volume 1, then you could go back and watch the video replays, you know? Thank you, Naomi. Naomi says, most definitely, I look forward to the classes. Naomi's also saying, the drawing class is not just teach me things, it has challenged me to expand things that I draw. The other part is that there's so many people that are part of the Draw Along classes that already can draw. You do not need me to teach you how to draw, Naomi, nor does Dawn or so many other people that are in that class. It's just more of a challenge that the more you draw, the better you get. No matter how experienced you are, no matter how many times you've, how many years drawing experience you have, what kind of background, don't you guys agree? Is that if you just keep doing it every day and just drawing and drawing and drawing, so you'll always learn something when you take a different class. We did this still life contour drawing in this class. In the first book, we did this finish it mandala. We moved on to a still life with charcoal. This was a mistake page. We drew some simple flowers. Still life contour drawing, we talk about rhythm and composition. And then we did a finish it mandala again. Another still life drawing was in that book. We did a whole mandala in this book. Some more flowers. This was fun. This was a lot of fun. Naomi says, and I'm also expanding the mediums. Exactly, because we work with a variety of mediums. We did this with chalk pastels and color, and other ones, still life with chalk pastels. So we work with pen, pencil, charcoal, chalk pastels, ink. I mean, you could say pen, you could say ink. Good morning, Dee Dee. Hey, Pat Christie. So this is what we're doing next, this line art drawing. That's our next one. And then we'll be working on a mandala, and these little dots are in here as our guides. Then we're going to be working on a still life with a grid, but I thought that was the next one. No, I guess not. We're going to be learning how to use a grid to draw something. Dawn is saying it's a challenge and you still pick up tips you did not realize. Exactly. Sharon says, I am amazed at the talent I see in the postings. They put mine to shame sometimes. Sharon, let me tell you, you don't give yourself enough credit, because what you're able to draw for a beginner, because I know that you're a beginner when it comes to drawing. You do a wonderful, wonderful job. And last week we did these dice for our, that was a huge challenge, right? Remember the dice? And then we're going on to this tulips with line drawing. This is gonna be a lot of fun because we're gonna take it a step further than we usually take it. And then another line art drawing with pencil, moving on to another mandala, and then another still life with charcoal. So, and then we'll move on to this photograph, still life with soft pastels. So this is gonna be a fun draw along book. $28.99 for this book, which gets you into the group, get you the book, get you the draw along classes in that private group. Those videos are there indefinitely. I download them so that you can watch them on Facebook if you want to. I can give you the link for that. Sandra's saying, great for absolute beginners too. I thought it was impossible for me to learn, and happy to learn that I was wrong. So many people have said that. So many people have said that not only the, and same thing with the virtual paint parties too. People are saying that, is that I can't believe what I'm able to paint. So step by step, and very simple, very step by step. We talked about perspective in this. I mean, this wasn't just like, follow me along. We walked it all through. So I look forward to draw alongs. They're one of my favorite things to do throughout the entire week. Dawn made a comment. It's a challenge and you still pick up tips you did not realize. You do. And even I do too. Even just explaining it to people also challenges me to even just teach the class. So that's what's happening. So you can get that book on Amazon or you can get the PDF on my website. Okay. Just wanted to kind of clarify that because a lot of people had questions about it. About the draw alongs. Coloring camp is happening and we usually draw the camp hut. So a lot of people like that. So that's why I kind of continued with the draw alongs. Any questions about today's color along or what we're doing going forward? The next color along, the draw alongs, camp, anything else? Congratulations to Marianne Manders for winning a PDF book of the coloring camp book. So excited that Marianne will be part of camp. Lisa's saying, I have learned so much. Isn't it amazing, Lisa? It's fun. The best part is it's fun. Naomi's saying the warm-ups are great too because it practices what you are going to be drawing. Even things that you didn't feel secure, you go step by step, it's great. You know what? The warm-ups look like maybe like, what the heck am I doing this for, right? But you know what ends up happening, and I'm gonna show you what happens with those warm-ups too, is that, for example, when we were ready to draw this one, the key part of this is this shape, this kind of flat style oval. And if you can't do that, then you're going to have trouble getting the top of the bottle and the top of the bowl. And even kind of like right here, we call it the shoulder of this bottle here. There's kind of the lines you don't see. And we talk about that as we're going through it, each one. Sharon says, I look forward to Mondays and Wednesdays. Thank you, Sharon. And that's why we go through those warm-ups, because you kind of need to just, like, warm up a little bit. We're not going to do jumping jacks. We're not going to, like, stretch. Don't worry. We're not doing that. But we want to be able to warm up and just kind of sketch a little bit before we get going. And, hey, see you later, Sarah. And before we get going on the actual exercise. So this was a lot of fun. So anyway, we have a good time in that class. And they're like, I don't know, what are they? 30 to 60 minutes. Sometimes we last, sometimes we're quick. Sometimes we move on to the next one, from the reference photo. So not too much time, step by step. The warm-ups get you into the mindset of what you'll be drawing. Exactly, Sharon. Jean says she likes the warm-up too. I'm glad to hear that everyone likes the warm-ups, by the way, because I wasn't sure at the beginning when I did that. I wanted it to be, I didn't think that it was a good idea to just jump into what we're going to do without doing a little bit of a warm-up. And like I said, we're not doing jumping jacks. I don't know about you, but I'm not doing jumping jacks. I look forward to Mondays too, Sarah. It's a great way to start off the week. It's a great way to start off the day. Okay, my friends, I will see you, see the draw-along people on Wednesday. And if there's anyone's interested in joining us for this draw-along adventure, we're only on week 3 this week. And you can always go back and watch the replays of the videos. And that's about it. Hope everyone has a great day today. Stay safe. Talk to you soon.